Hey guys, this is my third video on Metal Gear Solid 5 Ground Zeroes, and in this video I'm going to talk about its lore. So this video is going to have a bunch of spoilers. If you do not like that, then don't watch this video. If that doesn't bother you, or if you want to hear my thoughts on, you know, Metal Gear Solid 5 lore after you played it too, then alright, this is the video for it. So, very little story in this game. As Kojima mentioned, you know, Metal Gear Solid 5, he has a new direction with the storytelling where he's not going to be using cutscenes as much, and his cutscenes are going to be very short. It's kind of true, but it's still very Kojima-esque. Like, the intro cutscene is 10 minutes long, the ending cutscene is like 10 minutes long, so they're not short cutscenes by any, you know, they're not short. And the in-between cutscenes, they are pretty short. So, you know, I think the cutscenes in general, like, there's not much of it. And to me, I don't know, I really liked the long cutscenes in all Metal Gear Solid games. And all Metal Gear Solid games, not just 4, all Metal Gear Solid games had ridiculous amount of cutscenes. And I actually really, really enjoyed that. Like, I felt like that was a reward for, like, sneaking past all these environments and getting to it and getting to learn all the story. I really liked it. You know, the Metal Gear Solid 4 ending sequence, it gets a lot of flack for being like this 90-minute movie where you don't really play anymore. I don't know, but that was an amazing closing of a 25-year-old saga, you know, about Metal Gear Solid story as a whole goes over a century. It's 100 years of a plot. And so to close that out with that one really, really long ending sequence and an epilogue to top it off, like a 20-minute epilogue where Big Boss is talking, I think it's pretty, I liked it. So this new direction that Kojima is going with less cutscenes, less, you know, more that kind of cutscene storytelling, to me it's not such a great thing, but he is being more subtle, kind of in certain areas, more like blatantly like just dark overall. In many other areas. The overall story of Ground Zeroes is extremely simplistic. You have to rescue two prisoners. One is Paz, one is Chico, two characters from Peace Walker. So if you haven't played Peace Walker, Ground Zeroes is kind of like, it already assumes that you kind of played it. The story doesn't make, the way that the Ground Zeroes is told, it doesn't make any concessions for people who haven't played Peace Walker. There is a backstory that you can read on in the menu, and it's 11 pages of text, which I thought did a pretty fantastic job of summing up the whole Snake Eater and Peace Walker saga. So I think it's great. It catches up a lot. So, but it kind of just the cutscenes themselves, they do not assume that, they already assume that you played Peace Walker or that you know what happened in Peace Walker. You're not missing out too much. I guess the story is very simplistic. Big Boss goes in to rescue the two prisoners. He rescues the two prisoners, and then his base gets blown up because it was all a ploy by Cypher or by this XOF organization, and there's not much. It's pretty much what happens, and Paz dies. And I know Paz's kind of sequence has been very controversial. It's very graphic, and this is Kojima showing violence without, senseless violence without justification. There's been that talk on IGN. I think her name was Lucy. That's what she said. I don't really agree though. Like it's a pretty graphic scene, and it's centered in Japan because it's a graphic scene. But like, it's not any more graphic than many other video games, I think. It gets very like, was there a point to showing us somebody's intestines? Probably not, other than maybe just to say, hey, you know, this is, even in a video game, we could do this now, because you might just kind of like, here's what's going on, you know, but there wasn't any torture sequence shown in the game. There are very, a lot of allusions to horrific torture, you know, Chico's nail on his foot, the way these, a lot of the audio logs you hear of torture, that stuff, I think, was very haunting to me. Like, the stuff that you hear but you can't see, The audio logs in this game, freaking amazing. Learning Pause's motivations through her audio diary, and anyway, the audio stuff, fantastic. I think just those audio log stuff made me like that feel validated in purchasing Ground Zeroes. I'm just like, wow, okay. I mean, Peace Walker had great audio tapes too, but it's just like, man, this is why I got into the Ground Zeroes, to get more into this stuff. But the main kind of cutscenes that show hardly much of anything, and I feel like there are no surprises in Metal Gear Solid Ground Zero story. I feel like I've already expected all this to occur, which is kind of, so I've been thinking about the opening sequences of all Metal Gear Solid games. Metal Gear Solid 1, I can't really make a comparison, but Metal Gear Solid 2, the tanker sequence, Metal Gear Solid 3, the Virtuous mission, and Metal Gear Solid 4, Act 1. Act 1, what is it, Solid Sun? So Act 1 was actually, I feel like it's a much longer and bigger game. Act 1 of Metal Gear Solid 4 is probably larger and bigger and much more storytelling than Ground Zeroes. So that already tells you that, like, Metal Gear Solid 5, the storytelling, the experience, the content, very small. Very small amount of content. So that's pretty disappointing. But when you compare it to the opening sequences of the previous three Metal Gear Solid games, maybe even Peace Walker, it fits in line. You know, there aren't too many surprises, except maybe like one kind of thing at the end, like things blow up. You know, things blow up all the time in the intro sequences of Metal Gear Solid's games. In the 2, the tanker blew up. In 3, freaking an entire city was nuked, or entire facility was nuked. In 4, there were not many stuff blowing up, but by the end of Act 1, people were like beating each other up because of nanomachines and things like that. I can't remember too much of Peace Walker, but it makes sense the way it is. If you kind of imagine Ground Zeroes as the opening sequence of a Metal Gear Solid game, it makes sense. But there are no surprises, but that's to be expected. I think the big surprises usually happen near the very end of a Metal Gear Solid game. And so I'm very excited to see what that would be like in Phantom Pain. But the plot of Ground Zero is very simplistic, and kind of like it's graphic, maybe for just too graphic for no reason. But I do like the darker kind of theme and approach of Ground Zeroes. It's not afraid to go anywhere. It'll go wherever it wants to go that Kojima wants it to go. And I think that's pretty cool. I really like that about Ground Zero, that it's not afraid to do anything. Is it, you know, does it need to give a justification for why it's doing it? Is it weird? I don't know. Like, there can be many arguments about it, but so far, like, this is a taste of what's to come, and I think that's okay. I think overall, that's pretty much all I have to say about it. There's not much to say at this point. It is kind of just a small sample of what Phantom Pain is. So when I get, you know, when we get Phantom Pain and we could tie this to the story of Big Boss's eventual creating of Outer Heaven, then I think I can say a lot more. At this point, like, not much I can say. I really like the backstory that they Ground Zeroes had about Paz and Chico. That dynamic was great. Paz is now dead. I don't really know how I feel about that. And Paz in Peace Walker, I don't really like Paz as a character that much. I really did like the fact, like, you know, Paz is being like a double agent, and, you know, but there were some very tasteless things done with Paz as a character in Peace Walker. You know, that you could see through her clothing, and she's a 15-year-old girl. I mean, that was totally unnecessary. I agree with Lucy and IGN on that. You know, and her accent, I really like. Her voice acting, I really like. So I'm going to miss Paz. In a lot of ways, but her death, dying like that, and that in effect being why Big Boss goes into coma, I think it's a pretty good plot device. I think I'm very interested to see what new characters are going to be revealed in Phantom Pain, because in Ground Zeroes all the characters are not new except Skullface. There is one audio tape I discovered where, you know, Skullface kind of reveals his past and talks about himself. I think that was pretty interesting. I think Skullface has a really great potential to be an awesome, freaking, amazingly interesting character. And I'm definitely looking forward to that. But that's kind of my thoughts on Ground Zero lore in general. Not too much to talk about. You know, very simple plot, but it's definitely exciting to see where it goes from here.